Can you see the picture on the screen?
Oh my God! No, 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 no. She really pushing people to look like this? You know what? I'm sorry. She look crazy. Okay, I don't want to be rude. I really don't. Que caca essa bicha? She look crazy. She like a zombie. Oh my God. She really out here teaching people how to look casket ready? Because what is this? This ain't self-hate. I don't know what it is.
I am the Mademoiselle and this is my channel. Today we are going to be reacting to a skin bleaching video. Now this is a video I just happened to come across because I wanted to do a video on the dangers of skin bleaching and skin bleaching and mental health, etc. And this video came up and I was just like, okay, not only is this video on skin bleaching, but her entire channel is practically on skin bleaching, and I was just like, oh no, I have to see this. Not going to link this because I do not want anyone to attack this girl because she got enough hate. She got over 10,000 dislikes. We already know what the public opinion is about this woman. So if you do happen to find this video on your own time, you ain't get it for me. Get excited. Uploads Monday through Friday this entire month of November. We're doing No Stop November. Smash that subscribe button. Turn on that notification bell. We not crunk here. We crunk on the Haitian channel. Go subscribe over there as well because it's lit. Learn about the voodoo religion, Haitian politics, as well as my life living as a Haitian American. Also, this is my Pro Common Sense hoodie. We got it on a t-shirt. We also have other designs. All information you need. And all the other stuff you guys always ask me in my comment section can be found down below. The reason I am doing this video is because I do not want any of you to be like this woman and go out and bleach your skin because people have been bullying you because you think you will get more attention, or just in case you have some internal self-hate issues. I want all of you guys to love yourselves. I want all of you guys to take care of yourselves because skin bleaching can be very, very dangerous and can really mess up your health. I understand if you're trying to lighten your knees, lighten your armpits, stuff like that. Like, that's just common sense that stuff like that is like not that serious. But when you go to the extent to like bleach your entire skin, you definitely have to have some type of self-identity issue. And also, if you fuck around and you have kids and stuff like that, you're basically transferring that self-hatred onto them because you're showing them that it is okay to lighten your skin or okay to 100% change yourself when you do not like something. Make sure you guys comment down below. Have you ever bleached your skin? Why or why not? Do you know anyone who has? And what do you know about skin bleaching, how to bleach your skin, and what the dangers are? Also, comment down below, why do you think people are still doing this in 2020? Especially now that there's so many like self-love and acceptance type of campaigns. I would have thought that this was something that like doesn't happen that often, but this video is literally only like a year old.
You haven't read about the title just yet. Today's topic is gonna be about 5 tips on how to transform a dark skin tone to a light skin tone without complications. If you are not interested in skin lightening, this particular video is not for you. So please,
guys, we're not interested in skin lightening, so this video is definitely not for us. So with that being said, thank you guys so much for watching this video. Make sure you guys like, share, subscribe, do all that. Y'all believe that? So we're about to watch this anyway. Even I do these types of disclaimers, right? And people gonna still watch it anyway. Because at the end of the day, sometimes people just want to be objective. Like, I honestly really want to know, like, what she's about to tell people to do. Because this whole no complications thing is already bullshit. It's already a lie. The fact that I already know she's about to sit up here and be like, oh, I don't hate myself, it's not self-hatred, it's going to be a lie. Because that's how all these videos go. It's always going to be dangerous to lighten your skin, especially when you're going from one extreme to another.
Putting this video out for those who are desperately need to transform without complication.
Desperately need to transform. No one needs to desperately transform their skin color from one color to another skin color. What you need to do is get your ass desperately in some damn therapy. I can never understand how people can spend thousands of dollars on a new ass, thousands of dollars on skin bleaching, thousands of dollars on possessions that will do nothing for them because you can't take them when you die. Soul is your soul. That's literally all you have. as well as your destiny and your legacy in this world that you pass on to others, your energy, that's literally all you have. So why not put more money and energy into self-care? Why don't you go put that money into some therapy? People would much rather go under the knife. People would much rather sit there and bleach their skin and do all of that instead of trying to figure out what the hell is wrong with them. If you hate yourself, if you do not like yourself, there's nothing you can do about it if your mind is not right. If you do not go figure out why you feel that way, no amount of bleaching, no amount of cutting, no amount of changing is going to fix it. I understand if people get into car accidents and now their face is deformed, boom, they want plastic surgery. I understand some people have like little dark spots. Okay, lighten it up to even the rest, whatever. However, when it comes to like sitting there, like changing your entire skin tone, sitting there trying to get a whole new body, like it's way too much.
Oh my God, don't police people's decisions.
First of all, I said what the fuck I said. You're not gonna do anything about it. And what? You mad or not?
Back into a live skin. Without complication. I know some of you be like, she's about to say. But before I go ahead and get started, if you haven't been following me on Instagram or Snapchat, I recently launched a product.
All right, we're not promoting her nonsense, so let's carry on.
I'm doing great. All right. He's on Amazon.
This girl is so annoying, bro.
Number one, get a lightning product.
No
I
shit.
Probably transform without
common sense.
Lightning ingredients. So number one is get a lightning product. Whichever you can afford, darling, get a lightning product. Can you see the picture on the screen?
Oh my God! No, 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 no. She really pushing people to look like this? You know what? I'm sorry. But honestly, do as I say and not as I do. She look crazy as hell. Okay, I don't want to be rude. I really don't. Que caca sa misha? She look crazy. She like a zombie. She's like a zombie leak, actually. Oh my God. She really trying to teach people how to look like this? She really out here teaching people how to look casket ready? Because what is this? Bro, nah, bro. I've never seen skin bleaching to this extreme. This ain't self-hate. I don't know what it is. This is, oh my God, I'm afraid to press play. She dead serious? This is not, I don't think this is punked. I feel like this is real. Hey!
Very different product can be. You probably be thinking, oh, is it real? My darling, it is real. At least you can see how light my skin is. So get a lightening product from. Number two, avoid mixing between products. Oh my God, some people always do this mistake. Do not mix too many products together. Like that is gonna cost you a long time. Complication and the next thing, boom, you're looking for what happened, like what it brought this on me, like oh my God, do not mix between product. Number three, know your skin type. You probably looking at me and say, what has skin type got to do with this, granny? My darling, skin type got to do with a whole lot of things when it comes to skin lightening. You have to know your skin type. There are five basic kind of skin type. Like we have the oily skin, we have the normal skin, we have the dry skin, we have the sensitive skin, we have the combination skin. Whichever the case may be for you, you need a good moisturizer. So if you don't moisturize, especially when you have a dry skin, you get complications and you don't want that.
Honestly, I need a good therapist after seeing this mess. I don't even understand, like the fact that she's so serious. Like I didn't know what to expect when I clicked on this, but it's like, this is just so sad that people really go and look for this type of information instead of trying to fix it from within. Y'all, no amount of skin bleaching is gonna help what you're going through. I'm telling you this right now.
So, get a good moisturizer and I recommend you get this.
I'm kind of annoyed at the fact that she keeps plugging her product in. Like when you plug your product in, you do it in the beginning or the end and that's it. The fact that she's like intertwining her product within this whole thing is bullshit. Mainly because like I'm sure she got light without using her own product, because I'm sure when she realized how light she got, that's when she developed her own product, probably using some of the active ingredients of the other products that she used. Therefore, realistically, she probably doesn't even know if her own product works to that extent. Second of all, bitch, you're not about to be promoting that shit on my motherfucking platform. So I'm gonna be cutting all of that out. If you guys find this video, That's your business, but I'm not going to link it down below because I don't want no one to drag her because she already been dragged, and also because she promoted too much of her product and we don't want any of y'all to buy it. We're not doing this over here, boo-boo.
Number four, be consistent. You need to be consistent, baby girl. Like, you can't just be like, oh, I use it today and I'm not going to use it tomorrow. But you just need to be consistent to be light skin. Like, and you need to be patient. You also need to read the description of every product you get so you don't have to be bothered or be in a rush. You know what it is already, then you can walk around the clock. You go.
First of all, I didn't hear nothing about any of this being safe yet whatsoever. And this whole, oh, you have to be consistent, you have to be patient to be light skin. Or maybe you should just accept how you are because that's not how you're supposed to look like. These tips are horrible. Like, honestly, let's be real. Like, I'm gonna have to play devil's advocate. If I was like trying to bleach my skin, this definitely would not be it. She's giving me very basic ass tips. Like, I could fucking find this shit on the back of a Cracker Jack box. Like, he caca salamila.
Number five, avoid stress and be happy. Like, if you are sad or stressed whenever you're using a lightning product, chances are like you might not get the effect that you need. It might work slowly or probably not work at all. So you need to calm your nerves, baby girl. Like, calm your nerves. Drink a lot of water, eat veggies, vegetables, and take a lot of fruit. So you can actually feel it, like when the glow is coming out. Because when you're sad, you can't glow. You have this negative energy around you. You need to be happy to see the glow. You know what I mean?
What is she where is she getting her tips from, bro? Where she gets her tips from? A fortune cookie? What the fuck is this? I'm sorry. Like, I'm clearly not trying to learn how to bleach my skin. But like, goddamn, at least if you're gonna give advice, give advice. My God, I want my 5 minutes back. You have to be happy to feel the glow. Like, who the fuck says that? What kind of advice is that? That's not even... Yo, oh God, that's probably where the dislikes came from. I don't believe the dislikes came from, like, her bleaching her skin itself. I believe people literally clicked on this to get legit tips, and she's talking some hoopla bullshit, okay? If I wanted to hear a generic perception of, oh, don't worry, be happy, what I gotta beat through this berry, I would have definitely not went on YouTube to seek it, okay? Like, this is not no damn real tips to skin bleaching whatsoever. Like, she's really saying basic generic shit.
Boom. If you are happy and you do all these things I tell you, you boom.
Wow, these are the tips.
Now it's time for DIY. Who doesn't love free stuff? Like, who doesn't? Like, I do. You probably are looking at my screen and say, but I don't have money. Can I lighten my skin without spending so freaking much? Ooh, it's crazy. Like, I understand that. So that is why I'm here to give it an alternative. DIY. Get ready, guys. Get a pen. Get whatever you need to jot it down. It's just a little thing to do. Just take 1 teaspoon of lemon juice and also mix it with honey, 2 teaspoons of honey. Mix them together. Wash your face and apply on your face. Apply on your face. Do it consistently, like I always say. Be consistent.
She really telling people to put honey in lemon juice on their face? Y'all, do not go around putting lemon juice on your face unless you want to burn like the roach we're watching right now. What the fuck? Don't. Okay, yes, I called her a roach. I said what I said. This is ridiculous as hell. Anyone who thinks that it is okay to bleach your skin is a roach. Well, you sit here trying to be a whole 10 shades lighter. Because you hate yourself and you refuse to get help. You're a rat. You're a salopu. You're a macaque. You're a malfecte. Especially when you're sitting here trying to convince people and trying to tell people how to do the same shit you did. Instead of you sitting here trying to convince people to do the same crap you did, you should be trying to convince them that this is not a good idea. She don't look good. I think she thinks she looks good. She doesn't look good. And anyone who does the crap she did will not look good. You know why? Because you're not meant to be that skin tone. You weren't put on this earth to look like you're not of this earth. She looks crazy. She looks like a clown. Like, literally, she looks like that makeup that they the clowns wear on their face. This is unacceptable as hell. Like, unacceptable. Like, I don't know who the hell says she looks decent like this, but she absolutely doesn't. And I'm not the type of YouTuber to, like, sit here and come after people's looks unless they're blatantly being disrespectful. I also don't condone all of the fucked up comments I see on here, to be honest. But you have to call a spade, especially when the spade is trying to make everybody look like the spade. This is absolutely just disgusting, and I am disgusted that she's walking around looking like this and trying to teach people how to look like this as well. It's also not healthy to be sitting here putting lemon juice on your skin. Trust me, you might just burn depending on the type of skin you have, and it's just way too acidic for your skin, okay? There are lemon products out there, but those are formulated for your skin. Don't go putting regular, degular lemon juice on your skin.
Your skin good, I believe so. Hopefully, this 5 tips on how to transform a dark skin to a light skin helped you out. And if it did, please leave a comment down below. I really want to hear what you have to say. Encourage me with it. Also, subscribe to my channel.
Dare y'all to fucking go subscribe to her. If you guys go subscribe to her, don't come back here because this is fucking disgusting. Genuinely, I am disgusted because she really thinks that she looks good this way. And she refuses to acknowledge that she actually indeed does have a serious problem. With not even just skin bleaching, with everything, there is honestly nothing you can do that will fix you if you do not feel okay. I feel like I'm constantly saying this. Like, if you do not feel right with yourself, if you feel like you're ugly, if you feel like you're this, you're that, you're not going to feel better if you try to change it. No amount of plastic surgery, skin bleaching, or anything else is going to make you feel better about yourself because that is all in your head. Like, at the end of the day, yes, you know, the whole beauty is the eye of the beholder, which I also think is bullshit. At the end of the day, some people just don't look good, and that's okay. Like, some people are ugly, and that's okay. Some people just look good. That's okay. Some people are just badly built, and that's okay. It is what it is. Regardless on if you're beautiful or you're ugly, what you need to understand is all of that comes from you in terms of what you believe in yourself. People could really be sitting there telling you that you're the most beautiful person in the world, and you can still be like, damn, I'm so ugly, what can I do to change it? You can literally be ugly as hell and have the most confidence in the world, and people will sit in there looking at you like, why the fuck she thinks she cute when she ugly as hell? Like, that's just the way the cookie crumbles, because some people were instilled with a lot of self-love and a lot of self-respect, while others weren't instilled with much of anything. All of that is mental. What other people think about you genuinely shouldn't even faze you, to be quite honest with you. However, what other people think about you will not affect you if you have a strong sense of self. Will it probably bother you, and will you probably make a joke about it or talk about it or go off about it? Yes, but it will not attack you and dig deep into you if you know who you are and you are happy with who you are. People who sit here and skin bleach and all of this do not have a strong sense of self. You cannot go under the knife. You cannot sit here and bleach your skin and sit there and say that you are okay with yourself. Just be real with it. It's ridiculous.
People can do what they want. People do things for themselves.
Nobody's going to literally possibly put themselves in the position to die, literally put their health at risk for a cosmetic purpose without having a psychological problem. What part of that don't people understand? That is not normal. If you have a problem, at least admit that you have a problem. If you're insecure, at least admit that you're insecure. Don't be sitting there trying to lie, talk about some,
I want to look good for myself.
Like, you want to have a fat ass for yourself to look in the mirror? Let's be real.
I'm sitting here bleaching my skin because I'm good at it.
Like, come on now. I actually watched her video talking about how she bleached her daughter, which it was also, like, honestly, if you guys find this girl's channel, she did do a video titled that, but I don't think she ever got to the point of her actually bleaching her daughter. I believe it was people insinuating it, and it was a reading hate comments video. And in this video, she was talking about some, oh, she started bleaching her skin because she was good at it. And it's like, are you fucking serious? Like, this is not makeup, okay? This is not a skill. This is not hair. This is not like, oh, well, I started bleaching my skin, it worked, so now I sell my own products and I bleached myself. Here, I'm living proof. Like, come on, bitch. Do not compare this to wearing weave or wearing makeup, because those are temporary things. Now, I can agree that a little bit of a thing can be really, really bad. Like, if you're sitting there and you can't walk out of the house without makeup, you can't walk out of the house without literally putting on like 10 designer things, you can't get out of the house without literally not looking like your best self, so they say, there's something wrong with you. I literally had friends that if they didn't have a wig on hand or if their hair was not done, they would not walk out. I have friends that, I kid you not, I've never seen their natural hair. That's how insecure they are about their natural hair. Trust me, I've seen it, but at least with all these people I know, they're real about it and they'll tell you straight up, yep, I'm insecure, yep, I don't like my hair. I tell them all the time, oh, you're beautiful, oh, I like your hair, oh, I like this, I tell them. And no matter how many times, no matter how many men they attract, no matter how many times I tell them, no matter how many times their parent tells them, no matter how many Instagram likes they get, they still think they're ugly. They still think that they need something done, okay? And this goes from girls who literally are afraid to walk out without a wig to girls that I know who have gotten legitimate BBLs, boob jobs and all. Some of them are rich, some of them are poor, some of them come from amazing families, some of them are from religious backgrounds, some of them are from the hood. These are people from all different types of walks of life. And the only thing they all have in common is the fact that they are insecure. They think that they could just do this, that, and the third, and it's gonna make them feel amazing. But in actuality, after their 10th procedure, they hit my phone up talking about how their arm is leaking. Okay, they sit in there talking about how they cramping all the time. They sit in there talking to me about how they have horrible headaches, or now their menstrual cycles are worse, or now their face is peeling, or now their hair is falling out, because they want to do a whole bunch of stupid shit. If you do not love yourself, you need to go get some fucking therapy. If you want to skin bleach, you really need some therapy. Because honestly, once you fuck your skin up, it's a wrap for that. Now you really gonna be looking crazy. This is not the same as just putting something on, because this is very, very permanent. Plastic surgery is permanent. Relaxing your hair is permanent. Well, I mean, you can always cut it off. Bleaching your skin is permanent. And a lot of this damage can sometimes not even be reversed. Like, I have a cousin who literally chopped her hair off like 10 years and her hair never grew back. I'm not joking. Like, she's just walking around with a boy cut. Like, it just never grew back. I don't know why. Trust me, I have no idea what type of curse she gonna do, but her shit just never grew back. Like, there's just certain things you just should not do, because at the end of the day, you need to realize that whatever you're feeling is within you. It's within no one else. And once you realize that, life will get better. I promise you right now. Sometimes things are just a phase. Sometimes things are just like, you know, a moment. But do not take that little moment and make a life decision with it. It doesn't matter who's making fun of you. It doesn't matter what attention you think you're gonna get. It doesn't matter what you think is going to change. Nothing's gonna change until you change. With that being said, let me know down in the comment section below, what do you think about this video? What do you think about skin bleaching or other permanent procedures that people do to themselves? Also, comment down below a heart if you made it to this part of the video. Stay tuned for tomorrow, because uploads Monday through Friday this entire month. And I'ma see y'all next time.